So here we are,
getting started in that nice and comfortable seated position, taking your time so that you could shimmy to the left and to the right a little bit, even moving fleshy bits out of the way, sliding the sides of the rib cage to the back and rolling the glutes down to the ground. That way, we're actually sitting up a little bit taller, leaning in towards the universal line of energy and coming in towards that complete trust. Hands resting wherever it's comfortable. Chin tucks in softly. Welcome to this 45-minute class with Kate W. Mack from the space of your apartment or your home. It is a privilege and an honor. Take a nice deep, deep breath in. And a great big sigh out. Two more times like this. Inhaling breath. Big exhale, hollow the belly. The last time it changes, inhale fully and completely, and then hold the breath at the very top. Keep the shoulders nice and relaxed, facial features nice and relaxed. Sustain your exhale. Tip the chin directly down in towards your chest. And just let the head roll to the left and to the right. Maybe even pausing a few moments if you find something that really, really works for you. Eventually, your head is going to roll over towards your right-hand side and you'll hold it right there. Reach your left fingertips onto the floor beside you as you now send the chin down in towards your armpit, maybe down even in towards the collarbones. Continue just like this. Slide your hands out a little bit further if you'd like to and even arrive on the very, very tips of your fingertips or even of your fingernails. And eventually, the chin drops back down in towards your chest as you roll it over towards the left-hand side. And this time your right fingertips will come down onto the floor beside you, tipping the chin down into your left armpit, down into the collarbones or the center of your chest. Right fingertips migrate away a little bit more. You might even arrive onto the fingertips or even the tips of your fingernails. All right, friends. Back in towards the center, roll it to the left and to the right a few times and start to slide forward onto all fours, tabletop position, please. Once into this tabletop position, check in, hands directly underneath your shoulders, and the next inhale, drop the belly, arc the heart, turn the gaze up, but I want you guys to hold it right here. Migrate the shoulders away from the ears as best as possible, and even though your back is arcing at this moment, vacuum your belly button into the spine so that you could feel this, stretch out the transverse abdominals a little bit deeper and a little bit better. Prepare to round, press the vertebrae directly up in towards the ceiling and lean back approximately 12% or so in towards a child's pose. Only 12%. You could now even rock your hips to the left and to the right to get in towards the nitty gritty all along the lats. Some of you guys might even feel this in the obliques. Next inhale, drop the belly, arc the heart. Do not forget to vacuum the belly button in. Keep the neck long as you exhale, rounding back about 12% in towards that child's pose. Maybe a little bit more if you want to. We're just trying to wake up the spine right now. Very last time, inhale, dropping the belly, arcing, turning the gaze upwards. Exhale, round, press the vertebrae straight up. Side to side movements if you'd like, leaning back a little bit more if you'd like. Return back in towards this neutral tabletop position. Once there, send the legs back behind you one at a time for plank or high push-up. Keep your hands and feet as they are and pike back into the very first downward facing dog of this Instagram live class. Bend out your knees, sway out your hips. Watch out for hyperextension within the body and also hypermobility. The objective is not necessarily to try to get your head down to the ground, but rather to keep a long length of spine from the fingertips all the way up to the tailbone, roughly this 45 degree. Look forward towards your hands, bend very deeply into your knees, step, walk, or hop your way now up towards the front end of the mat. Second or the third toe parallel to each other, inhale, a half lift. Exhale, fold more weight into your forefoot, please. Inhaling, it's a half lift again. Big exhale, more weight into the forefoot. Very last time, deep breath in. Exhale, fold and hold. In this folding and holding, you can hold onto opposite elbows. You can hug the legs, scoop up the toes from the front, maybe even step on the hands from the back or even the front. What helps me, especially as a super flexi, is actually to keep a deeper bend in my knees rather than locking this out completely straight. Letting the torso go entirely and completely so that you can feel the traction all along the length of your spine. Prepare to release, soften into your knees, release your hands. Prepare to go all the way up into the sky and look up, coming in towards Samasthitihi, hands down by the side. Inhaling, hands return all the way back upwards. And as you exhale, interlace your fingers right behind your back and exhale, start to fold, bringing the hands maybe slightly off of your back or even keeping them there. Mama's on board, keep a wider stance within your legs so that you have some space. My quarantine friends, if you've been eating a lot, also wider space. All right. Lifting the hands up as high as possible, squeezing the shoulder blades together as best as you can. Release the fingertips down onto the ground. Pick up your left leg and send it all the way towards the back end of your mat. All right, take a deep inhale, straighten out this leg, big hamstring stretch. Exhale, lunge back in. You should be able to hear your own breath. Inhale, straighten out your right leg. Exhale so that you can lunge back in. Very last time, straighten out this leg, now hold it. If your leg does not go completely straight, that's okay. If you need to bring the floor closer to you, that's cool too. Use a block or even a water bottle. Those of you guys who don't have those things on hand, you can rest your hands on top of your shin or even on top of your thigh, coming up a little bit higher. Flexies, flex all five toes on your right foot, rock back onto the heel, toes up, sole the foot forward, and together, Care Bear countdown to the front. Prepare for a warrior one position. That means your back foot is going to stagger down to the ground at roughly a 30 to 45 degree angle. Return the bend back in towards this right knee, stagger that foot down onto the ground back behind you and start to rise. Bring your hands all the way upwards. Big old inhale. Exhale, optional, right arm underneath the left one as we move to Garudasana. If this is not possible, you can hold on to opposite shoulders. You can even reach your hands back up into the sky in the original version. If this is too much for the legs, drop that back knee down to the ground. But whatever variation you have taken, push your pelvis forward towards your screen. Bring your elbows forward and reach your hands up a little bit higher. You should be feeling a nice stretch all along the back of the shoulder blades. As we continue to lunge in a little bit deeper, find a mini back bend. Keep squeezing the tushy, keep driving the pelvis forward, and bend in towards the right knee for three more breaths. If it's possible for you to keep the arms like this, keep them and drape them down the inner line of your right leg. Sometimes the right hip will want to wildly swing out to the side, so drag the right hip back, left one forward. Flexi friends, fingertips will touch the ground, super flexies, forearms down. But more than anything else, I want to get you guys into the hips and the shoulders. Keep driving your fingertips forward towards the screen. Hi, Angela in Doha. Prepare for warrior two position. Release your hands and windmill up warrior two position. This one's a little bit different. Take a deep inhale, exhale. Interlace your fingers right behind you, shoulders up and down. Carry your hands over towards your right leg. Some of you guys might even be able to bend a little bit deeper so you have a shelf to rest these hands. Notice this right arm of yours, tuck it back, shoulders down. Lunge deeper, breathe steady. It's almost like your legs are trying to pull themselves inside the midline and then even playing with pushing the feet out to the left and to the right, seeing if that makes a difference. It should feel like a pretty good stretch for your shoulders. Return back, warrior two position. Straighten out your right leg and start to tip backwards, reverse this triangle. Optional, hand can stay down the length of your leg like this, or you can bend in towards your elbow as you lean back a little bit more. If you are bending into this elbow, imagine you were in a photo shoot and you wanted to bring the head of the shoulder forward. That should get you right in towards this area. Feels pretty nice. Okay, let's practice looking good. Bend your right elbow, put the hand on the back of the head, look up into the sky, practice looking good. Some of you guys, though, you have the capacity to bind your pose, and if you are binding, this left hand of yours sneaks up and around your back, and you hold on to your own right hand so that behind you, it's gonna look a little bit more like that. If you're not quite there, don't worry about it. Wherever you are, prepare for a triangle pose. Bring the right hand down towards the ground as the left hand lifts, wrist to wrist, 180 degree. Less about getting this hand down to the ground, that's collapsion, and more about this elongation or expansion. Let's put some fire into you guys. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, crocodile arms into the middle. Oh, I know. Inhale so that you could open. Exhale into the middle. One last time, deep breath in, exhale into the middle, hold it, reach your hands forward, hold it, pull back, warrior two position, hot dog, warrior two position, prepare for high runner's lunge, back hand drops, spin forward, arriving up onto your left tippy toes, deep breath in, exhale, hands to heart center as you lean your torso forward towards the front. This left elbow of yours hooks over towards the right knee. Notice if your prayers are being said at your right armpit, no prayers will ever be answered there. So push stronger into the right hand, bring it closer into heart center. Nice work, you guys. Keep this entire shape. Look down at your right big toe. It may take you several steps, but now left foot steps up beside the right one, side by side. We're in that prayer twist. Notice if your knees are not in line with each other, drag the right hip back so that they're even Steven. Inhale, Utkatasana, chair pose or powerful pose. Exhale, dive forward, hinge at the hips, please. Half lift, the sternum reaches. Plant your hands, step, walk, or hop. Either you're going into Bakhasana, crow pose, or you are stepping back one at a time. Those of you guys who wanna do cat-cow instead, you can. Otherwise, cycle through half plank position, cobra or up dog. Take it back, downward facing dog. Child's pose. In this child's pose, if you got a baby on board, legs out a little bit wider, you can even bring a block or even pillows to help bring the floor closer to you. If you have tight hips, same thing. And if you've been eating a lot like I have, same thing. This feels better. Curl up, my friends, and grab as much water and or coffee as you might need. I don't know about you, but I am sweating. Okay, friends, take your time and grab this ball. If you don't have this ball, do not worry. We have enough version for you. If you do have a ball, we'll take this ball and place it into the back of your left calf muscle, right in the belly of the beast. Ease yourself down. Shoelaces will be down onto the ground. Those of you guys who do not have this ball, no problem. Pick up your right knee and put it into the back of your left calf and apply downward pressure. Move the knee up, down, left, right, clockwise and counterclockwise so that you could feel all the goodness. If you have the ball in the back, we are rocking to the left and to the right. This is something that was taught to me by my nearest and dearest friend, Dr. Justin Tan, who I am collaborating with very shortly. That class will be on Friday. We'll be working together, yoga and mobility. Find a good spot. If you have a ball, you are leaning backwards. If you don't have a ball, push your knee down a little bit more and unbend your knee and bend it. For us, we're leaning back and we're rocking back left and right. Yeah.
These comments are funny. Come forward, everybody. Take that ball out and then put your knee back down. Extension of your left leg back behind you. The toes are on the floor, so I have leverage, but some of you guys will also tuck your right toes under exactly where they are and lift the hips back for modified down dog, stretching out this left calf muscle of ours. Flexi friends, really consider bringing your torso back a little bit more, even arcing the heart, flicking the tailbone up into the sky, almost like you're doing a mini up dog. Congratulations, second side. Back into this tabletop position. Grab the ball if you have it. If you don't, no problem. Those of you who do not have it, pick up this time left knee into the back of your right calf. And for those of us who do, put this ball into the back of your right calf. Ease yourself down and start to rock and roll left and right. If you can't ease back that much, no problem. Stay in a tabletop position, not a big deal. Lean back as much as you can. Breathe steady. There's a level of trust here that you're actually doing this because I can't tell. Okay. As close to the knee as, no, just right in the belly of the beast. The calf is quite large. That's a good question. The calf muscle essentially attaches pretty close down here and then goes all the way up towards the back of the knee and to the left and to the right. If you tinker around with where the placement is, you'll actually find a spot that sings a little sweeter than the rest. Now, if you have your knee in the back of the calf, apply a significant amount of downward pressure, unbend your knee and bend it. My ball friends, lean back a little bit more as best as you can, and then rock to the left and to the right so that you can also feel this in all of its glory. Okay. Steady as she goes, come forward. You can remove that ball out. You can take that knee out. Extension this time of your right leg back behind you. The left toes tuck under exactly where they are, and then we lift up, modified downward facing dog. Those of you guys who are looking for a deeper calf stretch, consider bringing your torso back towards the thighs, and then like you're doing a mini up dog, you flick the tailbone upwards as you continue to drive the heel down. Watch out for hyperextension within your right leg. Keep a soft, subtle bend. When you are prepared to, everybody, step back, downward facing dog. Bend out your knees, sway out your hips, and I hope that you have these brand new calf muscles. Yogi's choice, anyone who needs to flow through vinyasa, i.e. plank position to half plank position, cobra or up dog, do that. Eventually, I will see you guys back at the front end of the mat. Step, walk, or hop your way to the top. Half lift upon arrival. Exhale, fold second and third toe parallel. Inhale, half lift again. Exhale so that you can fold. Last time. Fold and hold, more weight into the forefoot. That way, the greater trochanter, or this hip bone, eventually is going to stack on top of the ankle. One day, the knees might come into play with that, but the objective is not necessarily to have straight legs. In fact, as a super flexible person, I actually like to keep my knees softly bent so my belly connects to my thighs, releasing all of this weight downwards to create traction in my spine. Shake your head up and down, left and right. Prepare to release. Hands come down onto the ground. If they're not there already, soften your knees. If they're not already, and rise. Swing your hands all the way up into the skies and look up. Exhale, samasthitihi, hands down by the side. Nice work, everyone. Close the eyes. Shrug the shoulders up and back right here. Nice and steady. Interlace your fingers right behind your back again, shoulders up and down. This time it's a little bit different. See if you can drive the hands down to the ground while simultaneously squeezing the elbows back behind you. Not necessarily trying to get the arms completely locked straight, but rather as you bend your elbows backwards, it should feel a little bit better for you.
so she is engaging ever so slightly. You can even play with tilting the chin directly down in towards your chest, and that might help to open you up a little bit more. Put a bend into your knees now. Slowly hinge at the hips, tip forward. It's optional. You do not need to lift your hands off your back if the space is not there. But if you can, go ahead and do that now and enjoy the stretch that you are feeling. Hands will release down towards the ground, soften. This time, pick up your right leg and migrate it all the way back behind you. We're about to enter into that hamstring stretch. Inhale, straighten out your left leg. Exhale, lunge back in. Hear your own breath. Inhale, straighten out your leg. Exhale, lunge back in. Last time, just like that. Inhale, straighten the leg, fold and hold. Bring the floor closer to you, however you'd like. Those of you guys who want to rest your hands on your shins or even your thighs, that's cool too. And if you need to actually have a bend in your knee, that's fine. We want to lovingly move into a place of expansion, but moving into places of expansion are never going to be done with force. That includes real life. Dang, she deep. Consider warrior one position. That means your back foot is going to come in at an angle 30 or 45 degree out to the side. Return the bend back in towards this left knee and stagger your right foot down to the ground. Prepare to rise. Bring your hands all the way upwards. Watch out here. Sometimes a tendency is we will flare the two ribs out and there's a very sharp bend in my back. Instead, bring the lower two ribs into the body, drive your tailbone towards the floor. That's different than tucking. You want the tailbone to go straight down versus tailbone scooping forward. Optional. Left arm underneath the right one for Garudasana, or the eagle bind. Anyone who needs to, drop down onto the knee if you must. Push your elbows forward, lift your hands higher to feel a stretch in the back of the shoulders. If you need to, opposite elbows, perfectly fine as well. Wherever you are, tilt your pelvis forward, squeeze the tushy. Opening up into the front of the hips, especially if you're sitting for long periods of time right now. Find a back bend. That's different than collapsing into your low back. You have to think about this shelf that is installed behind you, but it's a shitty shelf. And so you have to be careful. Lift your heart up and gently place it back on that shelf, as if you have to gingerly place it back there. Keep the arms if you can. Big inhale, exhale, cast down the inside of your left leg. Flexies, fingertips might touch, super flexies, maybe even the forearms, but whatever you do, drive your fingertips forward towards me. If you have your hands on the floor, then really consider bringing left hip back, right one forward, and bend into the elbows. There's something for everybody in this practice and in this world. Garuda, or the eagle, this guy, is actually a very revered animal and god in Bali. He is the protector. It is said that Indra was charged with the task of finding a place in the world for the gods and goddesses to live in. I'll tell you the story later. We gotta keep going. Pull up back to warrior two position now. Spin that foot. Now in this warrior two position, if there were ribbons hanging from your wrist, that's roughly where your feet would actually go. Big inhale breath, big exhale, interlace your fingers right behind your back. Interlace them the way that feels funny to you. Bring your hands now over towards this left hip of yours. If you can, some of you guys will be able to bring it over so much and bend this knee. It acts like a fist resting on the shelf of your leg. This left elbow of yours tucks into your body, shoulders down, as if you were trying to show off these beautiful dangling earrings that I gifted you. Lunge a little bit deeper, breathe steady. Keep squeezing
that left elbow back behind you. Keep bringing the shoulders down, even tucking the chin into your chest. Return back, warrior two position. Straighten out this leg. Watch out for hyperextension and tip backwards. This time, it's the right hand that trickles down. I personally like to bend into my right elbow, but when I do that, I'm bringing the head of this shoulder forward. That way, I can feel it right in the front of my shoulder girdle. All right, prepare. Practice looking good. This time, it's your left hand that bends. Put the hand on the back of your head. Lean backwards. Binders. This time, right hand slides up the length of your back, perhaps meeting the left fingertips. If you're not binding, that's okay. You can also hold onto your shirt in the back. Uttita, Trikonasana, extended triangle pose. Left hand towards the floor, right hand lifting. Watch out for hyperextension. Wrist to wrist, 180 degree expansion in the body versus the collapsion. Big inhale. Entering the spicy, exhale into the middle. Open, use your exhale to bring it into the middle. Last time, into the middle, hold it. If you can feel it, you'll say to yourself, ooh, she's spicy. Reach your hands forward. Pull back, warrior two position, hot dang. Prepare for high runner's lunge. When we do this, come up onto your back, tiptoes as your hand drops down and up. Squeeze the tushy, big inhale. Hands to heart center, bring your right elbow over towards the left knee. The tendency is that your hands will be up by the armpit, so you have to push stronger into your left hand to bring the hands closer to heart center. Look down at your left big toe. It may take you several steps, but now your right foot steps up beside the left one. Notice if your knees are out of alignment, sometimes that right knee is going to come forward, drag the right hip back so that the knees are even Steven. Inhale, Utkatasana, chair pose. Exhale, dive forward, hinge at the hips. Half lift. Arm balancers, take it away. Otherwise, for the rest of us, flow through Vinyasa. You can do cat-cow, or you can do half plank position, coming through for cobra or up dog. Exhale back, downward facing, everybody. Child's pose. Rock your forehead to the left and to the right. In this child's pose, if we want to continue opening up in towards the arms, you can glue the palms together to touch in front of you. Bend the elbow so that they go behind your head or your neck. Keep the elbows on the ground, but pull it into yourself. If you need more, walk your elbows forward, then pull it back into yourself. So Indra is the god of the skies, and he was charged with the task of finding a place in the world for the gods and goddesses to live. And he came across this mountain and thought, this is perfect. But this mountain actually belonged to Garuda, or the eagle. And so Garuda came and said, you cannot have this mountain. And Indra says, says who? Garuda says, says me. So he opens his arms, this giant wingspan, and he wraps his arms around the mountain and then wraps his legs around the mountain. And he holds that for like 1,000 years. Long story short, Indra does eventually get the mountain, and he does it by taking his thunderbolt and he strikes the base of the mountain and it topples into the sea. Curl up, grab as much water or coffee as you need. When the mountain topples into the sea, it is said then to become the island of Bali. But Balinese people have high regard for Garuda, the protector, and so you'll see these eagle statues in front of homes and also in front of businesses all over the island. And what we're doing right now, staying home, self-isolating, doing this Instagram live class, is protecting the whole, protecting the entire world. All right, friends, find your way back to downward facing dog. Those of you guys feeling a little spicy, you could go into Bakasana or crow pose. And those of you guys who wanna do regular half plank up dog, down dog, you can do that. Eventually, see you back in a downward facing dog, hold it there. Once you hold it there, keep softness in the back of your knees. Spread your sit bones to the left and to the right, but the tailbone up into the ceiling. Right leg rises nice and high. Stack the right hip, peel the side body. Watch this left shoulder, it wants to drop. Keep it even. Those of you who'd like to go there, flip the dog and open Kamachakrasana or the wild thing. Prepare for pigeon pose, knee all the way through for pigeon, land it down. If this pinches or hurts your knees, that's not normal. You have to bend your back leg in by a little or a lot, and you're leaning in towards an angle at a 45 degree. But those of you who have the back leg straight, then you are coming straight down the center. Body weight is neither falling over towards your right hand side, but rather suspended in the middle. There's a good sense of buoyancy here. Back toes, a personal preference. They can be tucked under, mine are, because I have sensitivities in my knees, but yours could be flat down on the shoelaces. Find your breath, tuck the chin under. Some of you guys might even keep your elbows on the ground, but you'll interlace your fingers and put it on the back of your head. Give yourself 10 double chins, like the more, the better, and push the back of your head into your hands and the hands into the back of the head. That will help to open into the back line. You can do that for just a little time or a long time. It's up to you. All right, friends. Slow and steady will come back out. If you want to, just for a few seconds, you could reach back with either your left or right hand to hold onto the back foot. And if you're like, nah, I'd rather not, no problem. Step back to downward facing dog. Cycle through vinyasa if you need to or want to. Eventually, I'll meet you guys all back there. Take your time. There's no rush. We are in self-isolation. And when you are prepared to, this time it will be the left leg that lifts up nice and high. Stack the left hip on top of the right one to peel the side body open, kneecap the highest point of the pose. Watch this time, the right shoulder, it wants to drop. Keep it as even as possible. And if you are going to flip the dog, go ahead and flip it. And if you're not, no problem. Thread that knee through. We're meeting each other in this pigeon pose. Remember, the body weight is neither dropped over towards your left-hand side, it's suspended in the middle. If it hurts your knees, nudge your back leg forward and lean in 45 degree angle to the side instead. Otherwise, we hang out here. If you want to stretch the back of your neck again, you could bend your elbows, hands interlacing, maybe the way that feels funny to you. Nuzzle the chin into your chest. The more double chins, the better. Push the back of the head into your hands and the hands into the back of your head. You can do that for a little while or a long while. Close your eyes if you don't need them. So many of us are doing a great sacrifice right now. We are not working, we are staying at home, we're not hanging out with our friends and our families in a physical way. But this is what we do to protect the entirety, the whole community, the collective. Just like Garuda, we have to hold fast. We have to be brave, we have to be strong. Last few moments, if you would like to go in towards a quadricep opening, you could reach back with either your left or the right hand to hold onto your back foot. And for the rest of us, we will be exiting this pose. Take your time to do so. I am going to see you seated position at the front. If you want to hop up there, you can. If you just want to like casually get there right now, you can do that as well. Once we come into the seated position, wrap the arms around your legs or hold onto your shins if that's more comfortable to you. Nuzzle the chin into your chest, stick the vertebrae to the back. Almost like you're trying to get like a little tiny ball. For those of you guys in my generation, it's more like Sonic the Hedgehog. And for those of you guys who are younger than me, then we're talking about Pokemon balls. And if you're a little bit older than me, we're talking about Popples. I still remember Popples though. Okay, friends. I want to get you guys in towards the shoulders. Now, this is a pretty tricky thing, but it's such a nice thing. If you do have this ball, this is where it's going to come into play. If you don't have it, but you actually have a block, you can use the edge of a block. If you don't have a block, but you have like something that protrudes that is soft enough, you can use that as well. Those of you guys who don't have it, no problem, stay with me. I'm gonna give you a variation. Imagine if I were standing behind you and I was giving you a shoulder massage where my thumb goes, that's where this ball is actually going to sit, right where my thumb would be if I were standing behind you and massaging you. So it's actually quite high, it's not very low. Lay onto your back, the knees are going to stay bent. Let's start with your dominant side. So if you're right-handed, obviously you'll be doing your right shoulder. If you're left-handed, obviously you'll be doing your left shoulder. Spend extra time where you need it the most. Okay, so this ball goes underneath your dominant shoulder. If you've gone here and thought, hot dang, this is like way too intense, the ball needs to roll closer to the ridge of your shoulder. And if you figure, hey, I can actually do some more, push the ball down a little bit more. This hand now goes up in towards the ceiling. Try to keep your back nice and relaxed. Draw vertical lines up and down. You will notice there are certain places that get a little bit more spicy. Please slow down when you get to that spice. And once you do, hand sweeps across the body and over. This is something that was taught to me by my friend, Dr. Justin Tan, the same person that I'm doing a collaboration with. You should definitely tune in if this is something that you are enjoying or you're getting a lot out of. Those of you guys who don't have this ball, but you do have a block or anything that protrudes, you could angle this so that it hits. I do have to cradle my head with my hands over here, and then the same thing up and down. And if you really don't have any props at all, not a problem, here's our variation. Take this hand, palm down, and sneak it underneath your back. If you have more, start to slide this hand up the length of your back, maybe between the shoulder blades, and then lay down. You can use your opposite hand to coax the shoulder down. It's not going to be as much of an opening, but it's still going to be a nice opening. The knees are bent just so that you can protect yourself. My friends who are doing that vertical movement up and down, the next time that you go back to vertical, go ahead and bend your elbow, bring the hand into the chest, and start to draw big, large, exaggerated circles, like the biggest ones that you can. Same thing, when you find points that are resisting you, you'll slow down, maybe rewind 2 inches, fast forward 3 inches. Those of you guys who have the hand underneath, see if you can also play with maybe shifting the body weight left and right with your hips. This is something that you can take away with you throughout the entire day ahead. Maybe a little tip and trick that you can put into your tool belt to help release out the tension of your shoulders. Whatever you are doing, keep it nice and steady. If the ball is there, keep it there for now. Those of you guys who have the hand down, shift the body weight slightly over to the other side, sneak the hand out. Everybody, relax your hand out to the side. Rest. Breathe deeply as if the ball could be absorbed into your body even more. If you have the ball underneath, you'll just reach in with your opposite hand so that you could take that out and then feel the difference between the two sides. Everybody, switch over to your other side. Those of you guys who do not have props, same thing, the palm is down. And then you'll just sneak this onto your back, trying your best to get it into the middle of your shoulder blades as best as you can. Those of you with the ball, it goes on the back, right where my thumbs would be if I were standing behind you and giving you that shoulder massage. If the ball is in there and it's like too intense, roll it closer up to the ridge of your shoulders. If it's not intense enough, roll it down the length of your back instead. Whatever you are doing, same thing. Those of you with the ball, a block, or anything that protrudes, hand goes up and down. When you find those points of resistance, then the hand will sweep across the body and down to the floor beside you, like all the way down, and then across, down to the floor beside you. And if you have the hand snuck up onto your back like this, you could use the opposite hand and gently give yourself some gentle pressure. The knees are bent, soles of the feet onto the floor, just so that you have that stability and the support. All right. Now those of you guys who are doing that vertical movement up and down, the next time that your hand goes back up, bend into your elbow, hand comes right in towards the shoulder girdle, and you draw big, large, exaggerated circles. When you hit points of resistance, you'll just slow it down, and then rewind 2 inches, fast forward 3 inches, rewind 2 inches, fast forward 3 inches, and then go back in towards that big sweeping movement. If your hand is underneath your body, you might play with rocking your legs like left and right. Maybe that helps. One of these is like the best investment that you can make for mobility work at home. I really encourage it. As we approach into the last moments, those of you guys with your hand underneath, sneak it out and rest it out to the side. Those of you with the ball, rest your hand down, but keep the ball there for now. Breathe deep. And if you have the ball, reach in with your opposite hand so that you can now take that out. And together, hug the knees in towards your chest. Okay. Relax, sit down. Already, we have arrived into the last few moments. Shimmy the shoulder blades underneath, palms flipped up as a gesture of receiving. Take nice deep inhales and great big sighs out. We rest here, knowing that the simple action of choosing self-isolation is protecting the collective. History will remember when the world stopped and the flights stayed on the ground and the cars parked in the street and the trains didn't run. History will remember when the schools closed and the children stayed indoors and the medical staff walked towards the fire and didn't run. History will remember when people sang on their balconies in isolation, but so very much together in courage and song. History will remember when people fought for their old and their weak, protected the vulnerable by doing nothing at all. But history will also remember when the virus left and the houses opened and the people came out and hugged and kissed and started again, kinder than before. deep inhales, big exhales. Let your head roll to the left and to the right. And wiggle into fingers and your toes. Turn wrists and point and flex your feet. And then because it feels good, going ahead so that you could take a nice deep stretch, shaking out the cobwebs physically, mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. Coming out of this stronger and kinder than when you entered. Roll over to your right hand side for relaxation, or over to your left if it's energy that you are searching for. Use the help of your hands so that you can press your way up in towards a nice and comfortable seated position. The hands will fold in towards heart center. There's a small pocket of space in Anjali Mudra. Anjali prays for 1,000 years, but in order for you to receive whatever it is that you are praying for, there needs to be space physically, mentally, and emotionally. Bowing the chin into yourself. Thank you guys so much for allowing me the privilege and the honor to be a part of your practice, for inviting me in towards your private space. It is always from the bottom of my heart to yours that I bow humbly and in your service. Namaste. I cannot wait for us to be out in the world when it's safe, so that we can hug, so that we can kiss each other, so that we can have all the good times together. But for now, stay strong, stay indoors. I love you so much.